the tendency to be more influenced by environmental influences or more influenced by the subjective factor. That's all.
Yes.
And you see, there are people who are fairly well balanced and are just as much influenced from within as they are from without,
yes.
Or just as little.
Yes, yes.
And so with all the finer classifications, you know,
yes.
they are only sort of point de repère, points for orientation. My whole scheme of typology is merely a sort of orientation, namely, there is such a factor as introversion, there is such a factor as extroversion. The classification of individuals means nothing, nothing at all. This is only the instrumentarium,
yes.
For the practical psychologist,
yes.
To explain, for instance, a husband to a wife or a mother. For instance, it is very often the case, one could almost say, it is almost a rule, but I don't want to make too many rules with it, in order not to be schematic,
yeah.
That an introvert marries an extrovert for compensation, or another type marries the counter type to complement himself, for instance.
Well, Dr. Jung, of course, tied in with your typology and quotation version, we, of course, know of your concepts of thinking, feeling, sensation, and intuition.
Well, there is quite a simple explanation of these terms, and it shows at the same time how I arrived at such a typology. Namely, sensation tells you that there is something. Thinking, roughly speaking, tells you what it is. Feeling tells you whether it is agreeable or not,
mm-hmm.
to be accepted or not, accepted or rejected.
Yes.
And intuition, now there is a difficulty.
Yes.
You don't know ordinarily how intuition works. So when a man has a hunch, you can't tell exactly who he got at that hunch or where that hunch comes from. It is something funny about intuition. Well, sometimes, you know, you can really find out how it works by finding the intermediate links. You see, it is a perception by intermediate links, and you only get the result of that whole chain of,
yes.
associations.
Yes.
Sometimes you succeed in finding out,
yes.
but more often you don't. So my definition is, intuition is a perception by ways or means of the unconscious.
Yes.
That is as near as I can get. This is a very important function, because when you live under primitive conditions, a lot of unpredictable things are likely to happen.
Yes.
And there you need your intuition, because you cannot possibly tell by your perceptions, by your sense perceptions, what there is going to happen.
For example, more specifically, what would be an example or a difference between an intuitive extrovert and an intuitive introvert?
Well, you know, you have chosen a somewhat difficult case, you know, because one of the most difficult types is the intuitive introvert,
yes,
you know.
Yes.
The intuitive extrovert you find among hunters, bankers,
yes,
gamblers.
Yes, yes, yes.
That is quite understandable.
Yes.
But the introvert is the introverted variety is more difficult, because he has intuitions as to the subjective factor, namely the inner world.
Yes.
And of course that is now very difficult to understand, because what he sees are most uncommon things, and he doesn't like to talk of them.
Yes.
If he's not a fool, because he would spoil his own game by telling what he sees. because people won't understand it.
Yeah.
For instance, once I had a patient, a young woman, about 27 or 8, and her first words were, when I had seated her, said, "You know, doctor, I come to you because I have a snake in my abdomen." I said, "What?" Yes, a snake, a black snake, coiled up right in the bottom of my abdomen. And I must have made a rather bewildered face at her. And she said, "You know, I don't mean it literally, but I should say it was a snake. It was a snake." You see, our further conversation a little later was that she said, that was about in the middle of our treatment, that only lasted for 10 consultations. She had foretold me, "I come 10 times and then it's all right." I said, "How do you know?" "Oh, I got a hunch," you see.
Yeah.
And really, about the fifth or sixth hour, she said, "Doctor, I must tell you, the snake has risen. It is now about here." Hunch. And then, on the tenth day, I said, "Now, this is our last hour. And do you feel cured?" And she said, beaming, she said, "You know, this morning, it came up and came out of my mouth and the head was golden." Mm. And those were her last words. Mm. Now, you see, that same girl, when it comes to reality, she came to me because she couldn't hear the step of her feet anymore.
Yeah.
Because she walked on air.
Yeah.
Literally.
Yeah.
She couldn't hear it, and that frightened her. And when she came to me, I asked her for her address. I never had heard of it.
Yeah.
And I said, "Now, I'm curious, I never have heard of that place." "Well, it's a very nice place," she said. Because a person cannot possibly speak of her experiences.
Yes.
Because everybody would think she's absolutely crazy.
Yeah.
I myself was quite shocked when I thought, for heaven's sake, is that case a schizophrenia?
Yeah. Yeah.
Because you don't hear that kind of speech.
That's right.
But she assumed that the old man, of course, knows everything, and he even understands such kind of language.
Yeah.
So you see, introverted intuitive would speak what he really perceives, then practically nobody would understand it. He would be misunderstood. And so they learn to keep things to themselves. And you hardly ever hear them talking of these things. That is the greatest advantage. But it is an enormous advantage in another way. Not to speak of the experience they gather in that respect, but also in human relations. For instance, they come into the presence of somebody they don't know. And certainly they have inner images. And these inner images give them a more or less complete information about the psychology of the partner.
Yes.
You know, that is, but it of case can also happen that they come into the presence of somebody whom they don't know at all, not from Adam, and they know an important piece out of the biography of that person.
Yes, yes.
And are not aware of it, and tell the story.
Yes.
And then the fat is in the fire.
Yeah, that's right.
You see, so the introverted intuitive has, in a way, a very difficult life, although one of the most interesting lives.
Yes.
But it is difficult often to get into their confidence. It's just a sort of a skeleton, to which you have to add the flesh, or it is a country mapped out, you know, by triangulation points. And that doesn't mean the country consists of triangulation points.
Yeah.
That is only in order to have an idea of the distances.
Yes.
And so it is a means to an end. It only makes sense, such a scheme, when you deal with practical cases. Well, I told you that case of that intuitive girl.
Yeah.
Who suddenly came out with the statement that she had a black snake in the bed.
Yeah.
Well, now, that is a collective symbol.
Yeah.
That is not an individual fantasy. That is a collective fantasy.